Hello everyone, and welcome back to our Let's Play of the Underworlds Cello.
Octavia Quest.
Exactly. The great Octavia Quest.
Wait, he left.
Yeah, I was kind of figuring that was the case. He seems to be on kind of a roam. I'm guessing,
Went left in case you could go left?
I'm guessing so, yeah. Oh.
Oh, hi, Mog.
Holy horseshoes! Oh, wait, I'm sorry. It's feeding off the head that you got the study key from earlier. When it goes hungry for too long, zombies may resort to cannibalism.
How do you know that? What should I do?
It's too focused on eating. Just don't go on your way and don't disturb it.
Focus.
Okay, I'll look at it first. Oops. Oh, jeez.
Oh, wow.
It got done eating fast. The severed head has its flesh picked clean. There's nothing but a hollow skull.
Poor Bruce Vince, you deserve better than this. Do you think he would still attack you? I'm not going to touch that. It's covered in zombie saliva.
I'm betting that zombies are very sloppy kissers.
Why on earth would he put that image in my head?
Amazing. Aw, he didn't go on to eat the spider. It would have been amazing if he did go on to eat the spider. Oh, he left entirely?
Huh. Maybe he just went home. He's like, whatever.
Whatever.
Mom is gonna cook amazing food, so.
Dude. Can investigate the wreckage. Try to move aside the wooden furniture, but it will not open the way forward.
Alright, I go around.
Alright. Guess let's try one of these rooms. Wander into a room furnished with entertainment, paraphernalia, and a billboard table in the center.
Oh, wait. Fuck. I love to play pool. I'm not the best at it, but I consider it the sport of princesses. I'm aware of the situation I'm in, but I want to break the boys at least once to relieve some stress. Jesus Christ.
Oh, you remove a cue stick that isn't covered in spider webs from the rack and head to the other side of the table.
She breaks boys when she's angry.
Only so. You must be either brave or nonchalant or just plain injured to pick up a cue at a place like this.
Boom.
Ouch, you sure is jumpy for a snooty little mare. Alright, Octavia?
I don't want to play pool anymore.
You're quite lucky nothing dangerous took advantage of your unconscious state. Sounds weird.
Wave.
That seemed like the implication to me, but man, so we got like a ghost over here. All swagging it up. Yeah, let's talk to him. 50 Spectre invites you to take a seat. Are you willing to share a table with him?
I assume as long as he plays, the zombie doesn't eat us.
Yeah, sure, what's the harm in it? Howdy, stranger. He, don't worry, little lady. I won't buy it yet. So, you gonna break the ass by gracing me with your name, or are you content with staring at me?
I mean, he didn't eat you or whatever while you were unconscious, so I think we can trust him.
Yeah, he seems like a cool enough dude. Jeez. All these amazing options.
You don't scare me, it's my option.
Many different answers race through your mind, but the mere sight of the ghost freezes you up, unable to speak. The air around you starts with to get cold as you're trembling. Fuck.
Is he trembling? I'm a TV.
That's a pretty name. Suits you fancy types just fine. Name Snake Eyes. It doesn't matter if I'm an equestrian or Tartarus. Gambling is my soul. What brings a prissy pony like you to a rundown mansion in the middle of nowhere?
Two.
Came here with a friend.
I came here with my friend, Rhinus Scratch.
Ooh-wee, what possessed you to come all the way out here?
We were invited to a party, but we ended up at the wrong house. Now Rhinus is trapped down below, and I am doing my best to release her by playing cards.
Ah, I see. That's mighty admirable of you to do. Yet, I can't help but feel sorry for your friend. Betting her life on some pony so incapable...
I beg your pardon.
Ah, did I hurt your pride? Face it. You're jumpier than a grasshopper riding a pogo stick. Or did you smack yourself in the head with the cue ball because you thought it was a good idea at the time?
Indeed it was. Well, I might be the most collect in these... I might not be the most collect in these circumstances, but I at least care enough for my friend to give my best effort to help her. And I cared a terrible way, motherfucker.
You sure ain't doing her any favors by sharing her name and location with me. How do you know I won't hunt her down but know who she did? Fuck. See what I mean? You're too careless for the good of you and your friend.
Wait, I had logic.
You gotta know when to fold him, lady, and when the time is now, you ain't even fit to save yourself. Well, listen to me. It's turning your fear and uncertainty into a weakness. Deep down, you have the ability to turn around any negative outcome.
You think so? Then I refuse to give up.
So, you ain't gonna quit, even if the odds are stacked against ya. Alright, I ain't stopping ya, but it ain't enough to have guts and brains. Sometimes you need to have luck on your side. I wanna see that luck first hoof. How about a few games of blackjack?
I appreciate the offer, but I have no time for games.
Figures you would say something like that. Thankfully, I always keep a trump card handy. You want information, right? What this place is, who it belongs to, and why it's crawling with dead folks with such mysteries. Beat me 3 times out of 5 rounds and I'll spill everything.
Well, I would like to know what's going on here. What do you think? Oh, why is the powerful voice in my head?
I suppose it couldn't hurt. Just keep an eye on him. So what'll it be? Wanna try your luck?
I'll play.
Fine. I ain't going nowhere anytime soon. Come back when you don't have your... Wait, what?
It's not good.
I thought I said the other thing. Okay. Wanna play blackjack, small fry? How do I play? Really? You don't know how to play blackjack?
I don't partake in gambling games.
Wow, your life must be boring. Coming into this house must be the only exciting thing to ever happen to you. Alright, perk up yours and listen. I deal us both 2 cards. I can see yours, but you can only see one of mine. Numbered cards are worth what's on them, but face cards are worth 10, and aces can either be 1 or 11. The goal is to try and get as many points as you can without going over 21. If you do, you bust and lose a round. If you feel the game you have to too low, you can always hit to get another card. Otherwise, if you feel like you can go no further, you can stand. Okay, I know this game. Once you stand, it'll be my turn. I'll try and beat your score with my own. If I do, you lose a round. But if I bust or don't have enough, you win a round. One more thing, Tender Hoof. If I deal you an ace and a 10 or a face card, get a blackjack and win the round with no hassle. Get all that, greenhorn?
So, pretty much is this either. You could cause this game to anyone, or you could also cause this game. Whatever that Star Wars game was named.
Yeah, that Star Wars game was basically blackjack, just you had cards to...
I know
to,
another game named
21. Change, at least, okay.
If anyone might be the same as blackjack, it might just be a German name for it.
Oh, it might very well be, but yeah, Kajak? Is that one? I don't think that's right. But anyways, yeah, the card game, and that was just literally blackjack with,
Pazok,
yeah. It was, you're right, it was Pazok, and, you had cards that could edit, which was cool. I think that was my favorite thing about it, was you could, like, change the odds with having, you know, cards.
It became kind of imbalanced when you had a good deck.
that is true, yeah. Good deck was definitely everything in
Let's
that.
Play.
Okay. Ready
like
for my
game.
Cards to tan your sorry hide. I
like
it
this
too.
Game in overall, and I like... Oh my god.
I think that's...
Wait, how does he have minus scratch cards?
I don't know, jeez.
So wait, are the lower ones ours or his? They're ours, right?
No,
and now
the
we
lower
already have
ones...
20?
Yeah, we already have 20, so stand. Not bad, but don't get cocky. Okay, we won the first round then. So we start with a 10. Hit me.
Oh, hit.
Bad luck. Heh, you're lucky. I'm not playing for keeps. 5. Okay, hit. 13, yeah. Hit. Remember, the point of the game is to win.
I suck a dick, ghost. Maybe just standing. Why is that a how 1? Is that a 10? What is that?
How much is, Joker? I think that's a 7.
Or I saw all the face cards, he said it was 10.
Okay, then, no, you're right. Then we have, yeah, we have
Aces 20. 1 or 11, right? Okay. Yeah, so yeah, it's yeah. 20.
Okay, stand. Last going, but your luck can turn around at any time.
There's only one guy left.
Yeah.
You know, I did tell us what happens if you lose. Yeah, you're gonna stand, even though it's not really great.
Yeah. Is it gonna get lucky? And that's all she wrote. You're not fit to survive the night, I reckon. Ah, darn it. Close, but no cigar. Takes a little to lose it all. He's actually, he's a cool guy. He doesn't even hurt us if we lose. So all it is just playing until you win, which I can appreciate. I mean, not everyone's thing is blackjack. Blackjack not entirely the
most scared game ever.
Yeah. I guess it's
so wait, that's,
1. So we yeah, have 16 hit. No.
The problem is that you go first, which is kind of lame.
Yeah. It's just...
13.
16. Yeah, up keep. Probably not gonna beat that. I'm stopping here. Let's go again. Oh, he got the same. Okay, great. 17. I'll just keep it. That's all. Yeah, okay.
Oh, no.
Oh no!
And suddenly, Baghdad was ghost. That's just what this part is going to be.
Wow, well, aren't you lucky stuff? That's quite a compliment coming from a ghost.
What? Things? I don't even know what that means. 10. Hit.
Yeah. Nice. Hit. Yeah. Perfect. Whew, okay, one more round. And we have several. Okay, that is 16 hit. Nope.
Various deck has an has a lot of face cards, more than you expected to.
Yeah. Ooh, stand. That's for me. Congrats, Greenhorn. Not bad at all. I guess he ain't a complete pushover. All right, Greenhorn's a deal a deal. I'll let you in on some information. You can ask about myself and the rest of the undead posse.
Is there anything else that we can touch on, like, was responsible for this nightmare?
I suppose I could if you beat me in another one of my games.
Not interested. I have no time to waste to find a way to help Viner.
I see. Then's about time on something. I know location, a couple magic scrolls that might help you survive.
Magic scrolls? What didn't you say? I mean, go on.
You really need to work on that poker face of yours. Anyways, come talk to me if you want to have a chat or play a game.
And then she's like, no.
She's like, out. But that's pretty great. Alright, so I'll go save and then I'll come back to him.
I feel like you're gonna walk into a zombie this time.
I probably am. That's why I'm going to go save, just in case, like, I get screwed over by anything like that. And I really... Okay, good, I didn't. Because I really, you know...
You should save on it.
Oops, I'm sorry. You're right, I should have saved on a different file.
Dying for you, now the zombie is gonna fucking kill you one day because you already triggered him.
Right, right. That's true.
I don't have no idea where you went.
Huh?
I don't know where the zombie went.
Yeah, I don't know either. I assumed he would have gone somewhere. Maybe they'll eventually program it in, but maybe right now the zombie just disappears after that event.
In the face.
Huh?
Maybe he's killing, like, minus scratch and whatnot right now.
Oh, that'd be quite a thing. Actually, let's go back there. See what she has to say about, like, see if she's okay and see if she... Yeah, okay.
She's still alive.
I need help with something. Zombie code. Probably.
What? Is this a zombie code walking about in this house?
What? Like a zombie kid?
Yes, it's a preteen foil and he chased me across the house. What do I do?
Do you know how to hoof combat?
No.
Can you stab it with a knife?
That would mean getting close to it, and I'm not keen on being in a chomping range.
Well, either run away or throw something at it.
Snitch, I don't want to hurt it if I can help it.
What are you gonna do? Play it a song with your cello? It's a zombie! Kill it!
Oh.
Let's see.
Pool plate.
Table. Sure.
I found a room with a pool table upstairs.
Sweet! I wish I was there to play around with you.
There's something about the table, though. I can't put my hoof on it, but it feels off.
Maybe there's something you can do with it. It shouldn't be too hard to figure out. All you gotta do is mess with holes and balls.
God damn it, Miner. Let's get you Miner out of the gutter.
Oh, Vinyl, you're so amazing. But I'm sure Vinyl loves messing with holes and balls.
Yep. That experiences it.
Alright, let's finish talking.
Wonder if I would want an arcade version where you play Vinyl Scratch through the whole same adventure.
Yeah, I would love that.
She would just kick everyone saying in the face. It's like spider kick, zombie kick.
I hope he actually does that. Like, it'd be cool if the creator, after he finishes this, makes an alternate Vinyl Scratch mode / game.
Yep.
Spectre invites you to take a seat. Alright, I'm sure it's harmonic. Let's just start by asking about himself. That sounds good, right? Do him in order? Yeah. My favorite subject. What do you want to know? I really like this guy. He's pretty swag for a dead guy. Ghost.
Yeah, I don't even know what to tell him. He's swag for a dead guy.
Indeed. Jeez, sorry for the ear rape, guys. One sec. And we're back. Okay, so that,
what did you do when you were alive?
Nearly a century ago, every pony and their mothers traveled to Dodge Junction with one thing on their minds. Gold, gold, and land sakes, more gold. The Dodge Gold Rush brought in tons of prospectors, cowboys, and any pony else looking to make a quick bit, including yours truly.
I'm going to be optimistic. I presume that you took the time and effort to dig some for yourself.
Heck nah. That was just too much trouble. I didn't want to join the rest of those bright-eyed folk who would blindly dig around, hoping to find a vein or two. See, my plan was to get all the gold without the work, so I decided the best way to do that was to sucker them out of their cash.
Are you a good man?
Gambling was legal in Dodge, so I wanted to use my talents to work my way into other ponies' pockets and straight to the top.
But I'm guessing that something went wrong, according to your present state.
I guess the upside to being dead is that money is no longer an issue anymore.
But actually, Japan, aren't we gambling right now? Imagine we get out of the house and Celeste's like, to the moon, motherfucker!
Be pretty funny. Gambling is illegal in the Everfree Forest.
It's illegal everywhere, but in my pants. I don't know what that means. That sounds... But everyone has to like climb into Celestia's pants to be allowed to gamble.
Sounds like a good Molestia story to me.
How did he die? I don't mean to touch anything sensitive, but how did he die?
Word of mouth about me was really starting to circulate Dodge Junction. They were branding me as a low-down cheater. I figured it was time for me to make one more big gamble than make myself scarce. So I got all the town gold and collected and arranged a town-wide poker tournament. Ponies would pay some out of their hard-earned gain to take part in the biggest event around. The stakes couldn't get any higher. The amount of gold in the pot was over 50... whatever bits.
What? That much? You could be the richest pony in Canterlot with that kind of money.
Gets better. I participated in the festivities myself, and I'm the one who rigged the whole darn thing. One by one, all those gullible wastes of flesh lost everything they had, and I was the one that had everything. I bluffed and cheated my way to the top with swap cards and mirrors, and they didn't suspect a gold darn thing. I prepared my cart to get out of Dodge with my ill-gotten loot. Equestria was gonna be my craps table, with me, Snake Eyes, calling the shots. At least that's what I thought. But then I learned the hard way that bad luck wasn't just confined to a game of chance. It was can strike at any time, at any place. In my case, it was near the Dodge border, in the form of...
You were bitten by a rattlesnake.
Fate certainly loves the use of dramatic irony. Yep, bit me in the hind leg. I guess I accidentally stepped on it or something to take it off. I felt real sick and my body grew colder and colder as the desert night fell. No pony was around for miles, so my screams for help went unanswered. Then I felt one last shock before collapsing on the ground, dead as a doornail. I woke up to find myself outside of my body where ponies were gathered around my rotten carcass. They gave me a proper burial and took my gold back to Dodge while talking about returning my loot back with the rightful owners.
Despite the fact that you've gotten what you rightfully deserved, I'm sorry for your loss of your life.
I ain't sorry. Heck, I consider it to be the most exhilarating day of my life, all the way to the very end.
I don't know, being a ghost forever, it must be pretty boring considering you hang out in this house.
I know, seriously.
You're probably like the first pony to come around ever.
Yeah, I assume this would be pretty boring until we came around. He was probably secretly super excited about it.
It's like, amazing, someone's here.
But that's...
And then we almost kid ourselves of a boy.
Indeed. Well, I'm sure Vinyl's almost killed people with balls before.
Probably.
That's how you know it's a real party.
Then the boys start kicking. What?
I don't know. That sounds like a movie when the balls attack. But, anyways, yeah, I'm actually liking this guy's, like, story. It's pretty legit.
He's pretty swag, causing concerns.
Yeah. He's pretty...
He really likes shuffling those cards. Those cards must be, like, over-shuffled in the head.
Yeah, they must be. But he doesn't have a lot else to do. But yeah. What a way to go. Just death by a rattlesnake.
Maybe that black guy put it there.
Yeah.
This is Sam.
The Sam? Oh.
Desperados.
Yeah. that'd be a pretty amazing reference if like, that was the case. If just, we saw a scene of that and all of a sudden just a black skeleton comes along and he's like, oh, that's where I left you.
That's where I left you, picked up the snake leaves. Ah, it happens.
Oh well.
What's after that guy?
Want a little insider information before you go yourself, huh? Sure, I'll indulge your curiosity. When I witnessed my gold getting carted off, I turned out to find myself in the underworld with a bunch of other souls waiting to cross the River Styx. That man told me to get in line with them. When it was my turn, I got on the boat and made my way to the other side of the river. And upon getting close to the shore, I saw two gigantic cities surrounded by a wall with only one gate. The boat went under the gate, and I got off on a pier next to the giant courthouse. Connected to the courthouse is another series of high walls separating the two cities. Lot of walls. I went through another mind-numbingly boring wait until I eventually got to the inside. And when Egg opened the courthouse door, Egg witnessed the judge passing down his sentence. What? For her crimes in life, she was sentenced to an afterlife in Tartarus, one of the two cities of the underworld, a city of pain, torment, and lawlessness. Never did I see such a prideful soul cry so much. Finally, it was my turn. The judge sized me up, looked at my history, and declared that I was a swindler and a thief, and asked if I had anything to say in my defense. I knew I was up a creek when he went over my life, so I decided to play cool and said I was guilty as charged. I don't think the judge was moved by his carefree attitude, but at least he sped up the whole process.
Sometimes you just can't deny who you are inside.
Well, the judge threw the proverbial book at me. I was forced to step inside the walls of Tartarus. City was never-ending fire and torture.
No, I know where tech thing when you go.
Everywhere I looked, there were ponies, griffins, hippogriffs, diamond dogs, breezies, and all other sorts of intelligent creatures, either groaning in torment or pleading for mercy. I'm sure every breezy ever who died went there. Those were the weaker ones that lived with the anguish day by day. Me, I joined a group of no-good punks who decided to live out their afterlife and sit and cause trouble for everyone else. Sure, I got my share of punishment like everyone else, but at least I was spreading my pain to other folk.
By Celestia's mane, I hate to even set a hoof inside such a place.
Well, I wouldn't worry if your little queen cut mind over it. Odds are your goody-goody act will land you in Elysium.
Elysium?
Second city of Underworld, populated by the virtuous, the kind, and the creative.
So.
Yeah, it's practically an everlasting paradise. The streets of gold and sounds of music.
Ah, what a relief. I'm glad you have something to look forward to. I hate to be forced into spending the afterlife amongst ponies like you. Oh, sorry. No offense.
None taken.
So wait, how did you escape from the city of Tartarus?
Well, my little pony, that's another story for another time.
Well, that was gonna mention... So that's where the text playing when he goes. Because Celestia is building this shit. Like, anybody gonna pay taxes so that we can build underground torturing chambers?
Probably so, knowing how the world of Equestria works. Nothing happens if ponies don't do it. Not even the change of seasons.
Yep, so Celestia just... It's very expensive to be fueling those eternal flames and torment machines.
Sounds legit to me.
I saw the creatives get this, so I guess other club pick writers too.
That's good to know. I'd like to have something to read when I'm dead.
In heaven. But does that read club picks go to her, so contradiction.
Oh man. So contradictions indeed. Phoenix Wright, but okay.
Yeah, talk about something else.
Yeah, there we are. I figured you would never get enough of me.
Nah, I mean, you really want to tell the same story 8 times in a row.
I figured you'd get bored of that. So, tell me about the undead. So you're going to learn about the spooks and the walking dead. Don't really care about that show, but sure.
I don't care about how the fuck you ended up here.
Yeah.
You tell me about the ghosts. Something has been bothering me since I separated from Viner. The ghosts that have been following me keep repeating the same thing to me. Like, give up, join us, and other disheartening phrases, but nothing else, not like you. Nothing boogie down and let's dance. It's almost like they are...
dumb?
Right, yes. Very unintelligent.
I'm gonna level with you. Ghosts are like me or special case. We get to keep our memories, intelligence, and identity. Those other ghosts, however, are just collective minds. They're blindly following orders. They don't get to the privilege to know who they are, but they don't care either way. They only wish to grow in number.
Changing.
They get bigger in size and power by shattering the psyche of an unfortunate pony. Then they pluck the soul out to add to the horde. The empty body is then harvested and turned to a zombie. Scary stuff, but efficient. One last thing, if the ghosts take your soul, you can kiss your identity and the ticket to the underworld goodbye.
See? Change things. What if a ghost like you ends my life?
We'll have to see now, won't we? Indeed. Dramaticness. But, that's actually a pretty cool mythos, the ghosts it's... here.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense. I mean, that's, I guess, how necromancers work. They fuck you over.
Yeah. Necromancers, they fuck everyone over.
What can you tell me about the zombies?
Tain't too much to tell. They're slow, they're stupid, and they love to eat.
Yes, but how does one even become a zombie in the first place?
Simple matter. If one were to bite you, the dark magic that courses through them would go into your bloodstream.
Sneeze, sneeze.
Then your blood turns in sickly green and bam, you become the newest card-carrying member of the Dawndead Club.
Is it at all possible to communicate with them, or at least get them to listen?
Don't bother. While they can still be able to speak, they have no real intelligence. They run on instinct and nothing else. Heck, you can get lucky and witness one of them trying to do stuff they remember doing when they were alive. Don't mistake it as friendly gestures, though. You're still a big piece of fresh meat for them to sink their teeth in.
Okay.
It's pretty standard zombie stuff, though I do like their explanation. Once again, I'm like their explanation a lot of this stuff. Like the explanation on the zombie bite. It's not just because of zombies, it's because black magic. It's
dark magic.
Yeah,
black
which, magic. I mean, but it makes more sense than because zombies. Because normally... Because, I mean, normally there's kind of the whole survivor thing of the original outbreak, but then if you get bit, you still turn into a zombie, even though it's like, but aren't they immune, though? You know, here it's just like, oh, black magic. That explains it a lot better, I think.
No, it's always the black magic. It's all, that's why we don't teach magic to black stars anymore.
Exactly. That's why the... I don't know.
I have to play cards for a score.
Well, alright. Glad to see you're in a gambling mood.
Are you going to be playing blackjack again?
No, I'm bored of that game. We're going to be playing high-low. It's much more fun.
Sounds sexy, huh? If I win, you give me a score, right?
Sure, if you win. But what have you to offer me in case you don't?
Ah, so we're truly gambling this time, I'm afraid I don't have anything a ghost would want.
Oh, I wouldn't think so. There's one thing you could put on the table for some pony like me.
What could I possibly give?
Let's make this exciting. How about if I win, you give me... your very soul.
What? Don't seriously think I...
True gambling is all about winning it big or losing it all. You're already gambling your life by being here. Why worry about little old card game?
We gotta
lose.
Or
do you
not
want to save Vinyl's life by playing it safe? Before you can accept my offer, though, I recommend you go downstairs and record your last words. So want to play? He was thinking just what I was thinking. I'm going to go back and do a save.
I'm gonna go save, nigga. Fuck.
What?
He's so white that I can't not call him that.
He's pretty white.
Though
I was hoping she would ask what he would actually want a soul for.
Oh. Well, I was hoping this was gonna go in completely different directions.
the sexual kind?
I don't know. Don't look at me.
Oh, Sapare, you and your necrophilia.
Actually, I don't have any necrophilia. I don't think ghosts really count into that.
Yeah, they're dead.
Yeah, but it's not what normally people would think of, I think.
Well, yeah, but I guess I see what you're saying. Alright, let's have a game before... Okay, let's lose a game and then we'll... Yeah.
Then we actually have a go. I mean, a game.
Yeah.
I don't even know what the rules are of fine, though. I like how she's like, oh, man, I already knew that, you know that, right?
Yeah, I know. Let's see. Well, I think it might be kind of self-explanatory by the name, but not completely. So how do I play? It's real simple. I'll start by dealing the first card, and then you tell me if the next card is higher or lower than the previous one. After you make a guess, I draw the next card to see if you're right or wrong. Then I'll discard the card you guessed on and make the card I drew the next card on which you guess is higher or lower than the first, than the next draw. This keeps going until I run out of cards. Don't worry. I plan to use the one suit of 13 cards. If you get to the end without going over 4 misses, you win. Otherwise, your rump's mine. Here's a hint for you. Count the cards that I deal. It ain't gonna play the same card twice. Do that, and you might survive. You know, admittedly, maybe that really is what he wants our soul for. I don't know. It's sounds a little suggestive to me, Mr. Ghost, and I imagine you're bored, so...
Been bored for, like, centuries. Yeah, you were playing hard with boys when he came in.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do it.
I'm in.
That game actually sounds a lot better than Blackjack.
Dave, you know. Now this gets good. Also, to make sure you don't get away, or you could react, you feel something cold and slimy tingle your both your legs. It constricts you to the stool, blocking your blood circulation.
God damn it, Ghost!
Gah!
Oh god, what, the snakes?
Impressed? I learned the trick back in Tartarus. There ain't no escape, just play the game and hope that your luck's on your side.
This game is amazing, like, the amount of, like...
Hot shots of your prayers.
The amount of stuff it has is just amazing, I find.
It is indeed.
Like, it just, it doesn't repeat the same, like, it always has new animations, always new frames. Like, what Ictavius expression we had never seen before.
Right, exactly. That is something I'm loving. There's just so much to this.
The attention to detail is amazing. This is like a, this is like a real old game.
Right, exactly. And, you know, though it doesn't make any sense, I even like the decks. They're very reminiscent of that kind of thing. You know, the
And I mean, it's a ghost deck, so what the heck.
Yeah, so what the hell? It's a meta, but
so
it's
so we are losing
fun.
Purposely? Because
I think...
Say hi.
Yeah, I think we are, though I'll just make sure I understand, so... An obvious choice, right?
Yep, an easy one. Now, this one actually seems pretty easy, because you can...
So we'll save us both some time. Seems suspicious. Okay.
So, he replaced the old one and put a new one in there?
Yeah, that's...
So there's no two anymore. I would say low.
An obvious choice, right? Yep, an easy win for you. Okay, so you want to try winning this season?
Why did he replace the two last time?
Because I think he replaced it. I'm surprised he doesn't done that with the high cards. We got really lucky there, but I think it's because it's almost impossible to get below a two.
Okay, but I guess an eight. So there's an easy chance to stay better, I think, to go with low.
Right. I was just asking if I want to start lose, like,
purposes. No, I mean, we might as well see.
Okay. You know, it's go with big or lose it all. Oh, looks like somebody's luck is getting sour.
I like that expression.
That was pretty good.
I gotta go down again.
Odds are in your favor. Practice a knock on death door. Let's see if he answers.
I love this. Go down.
I see. Okay. So this guy, yeah, he's obviously... I want Wolf.
This time I'm gonna go high.
Yeah. Obvious choice, right? Yep, an easy win for you.
I gotta go high.
Too bad, Miss, but that's all their way gambling works. You're all mine. Well, little Missy, time to pay the piper.
Wait, you can't do this. This was, please don't do this.
No talking out of this one. You're about to have the same fear I had when I went to hoof with bad luck. Now I'm going to show you another reason they call me Snake
God
Eyes.
God damn it! God damn it!
Jeez. Surprised to see my little friends? I bet you just dying to meet them. Don't worry, I'll send you to the spirit realm as quickly as possible. As quickly as a whip, the spectral snakes sink their teeth fangs into your skin. I chuck your entire body, but you don't feel ill. Instead, you feel extremely cold. As you freeze up, your heart rate slowly stops to... Yeah. Your soul is now free from its fleshy bond. Your soul is now Snake Eyes' property to do with as he sees fit. Your body is all fine. Joins the horde in a similar manner. Yeah, not that stuff.
I mean, that Snake Eyes line was a lot less. Then whatever. I thank you for watching.
Thank you all for watching, and remember, don't gamble with ghosts.
Fucking heck.
He did indeed, but I think that was the idea.